These are like super growlers, so these are like fighter jets right here.
Thomas Hemm, born and raised in Ohio. He hails from a military family. His uncles were in the service, his brother in the Army.
I really wanted to join the Army.
But Hemm always loved the water, so his passion to serve his country pulled him to this branch of the military.
And I just kind of wanted to do my own thing.
Right after high school, Hemm joined the United States Navy.
When I joined, I had no idea what I was going to be doing.
We wear brown.
It just signifies a specific job.
Little did Airman Hemm know he'd play an important role on one of the military's most forceful threats to the enemy.
You know, we were in some places, Bahrain, Dubai, 140 degrees on the flight deck.
Oh, wow.
The USS Dwight D. Eisenhower. This warship is packed with a punishing arsenal of aircraft. The Hawkeyes, better known as the Screwtops, provide radar and surveillance. Navy helicopters multitask, doing search and rescue, ground support, and ship protection. The COD, C-2 Greyhound, is the Navy's freight train. Then there's the fighters. The F-18 Hornet and Super Hornet are high-tech hunters. And the Growler is an electronic warfare ace that can jam radars and tracking systems.
Like I said, this is what separates our jet from any other jet here.
Airman Hemm is a plane captain.
You know, I'm gonna go out to the jet, like I said, 2 hours prior. I'm gonna prep the jet, dress the cockpit, which that's what I was showing you. I'd tuck in them straps. That's called dressing the cockpit.
He gets the jets ready for the pilots to take over.
In the seats, like, we'll make sure all these switches right here are good and they're all the way off.
These pilots really depend on you.
Yeah, and they depend on us almost 100%. Okay, sir, hands off, belly check.
Hemm sets every button, pulls all the pins, and looks for any potential problems.
Every time we come out here, we check everything over again and again and again.
And then the jet,
it's gonna get louder and louder, and I'm gonna say, sir, it's good.
Is handed over to the pilot.
I'm gonna be looking at him one-on-one, and then he's gonna say, okay, I'm ready. I'm reassuring everybody that, okay, this jet is good to go. There's nothing wrong with it, it's 100% efficient. It's gonna go up there, it's gonna do its job, and it's gonna come back.
It's what some would call controlled chaos on the flight deck. It's a very dangerous job. Case in point, March 2016, an arresting cable on the deck snapped as an E-2C Hawkeye comes in for landing. The Screwtop plunges over the edge. The pilot has 1 second to react and manages to recover. But several people on the deck suffered serious injuries from flying debris, many treated in the ship's hospital. No one was killed.
You know, you gotta be on the lookout, you gotta keep your head on the swivel, and you know, make sure the guy next to you is safe, also as yourself.
First watch, set by.
The crew of the Mighty Ike just got back from a 7-month deployment, and morale is high. Operation Inherent Resolve. The team launched 1,900 combat missions and dropped more than 1,200 bombs in support of airstrikes in Iraq and Syria.
You go through some rough times.
Yeah, definitely.
The job out here is tough, and so is the sacrifice.
But what it takes away from you, because it does take a lot of time away from family, you know, loved ones.
But this Ohio native serves his country with great pride and knows he is making a difference.
You know, when I go back and I watch the news and, you know, I see the Eisenhower out here and I see how people react to it a lot differently than I do, and they take a lot of pride in it. It kind of makes me feel good because I can say, hey, I was on there. I was there during Operation, you know, Inherent Resolve.